What is up, fellow nerds, and welcome to another Not Your Status Quo episode of What's Next. In this theory series, we go over what we think is going to happen next in WandaVision, and in this episode, we're going to tell you what we think is coming up in the final episodes.
After the ending to episode 7, there are so many things that we could see in episode 8 and episode 9, and one of the things I think we are going to see is Agatha explaining everything.
Messing up everything.
It's been Agatha all along.
Her in the opening episode and her being behind the chair in the Modern Family episode. But I got a stinking feeling that we're going to find out because Scarlet Witch doesn't know how we got here. I think she's going to do the evil explaining their whole plan.
I'm glad you asked that because I wanted to take this time to explain my evil plan.
And I think she's going to walk her through why she sent the Scarlet Witch to go fetch Vision's body. I think we're going to find out how she took control of her and what her overall plan actually is. Because it can't just be taking over the residents of Westview and having Wanda create, you know, Billy and Tommy. There's got to be a lot more to it. And we'll get into that in a little bit.
It was Agatha all along. Ooh, but
actually,
you know what? I think the best part is your fellow nerds did, in fact, as well as the rest of the internet, call that Agnes was, in fact, Agatha Harkness. We call that in our original theory video on WandaVision. That's right. As you can see, we are 10 for 10 on all of our theories, 100% correct all the time. Never are we wrong. Can't be disputed.
Oh, good for you. And how was it?
But I want to take a minute to talk about Agatha's magic. That's right. I've got another Doug Nerd theory. Let's get deep. I have clearly been watching way too many Marvel Cinematic Universe movies. I started rewatching Thor Ragnarok. I was watching Doctor Strange. I was watching Endgame. I was watching Infinity War. And I am obsessed with this idea that I don't think Agnes is using traditional magic, at least not the MCU version.
The sorcerers of antiquity call the use of this language spells. The source code that shapes reality. We harness energy drawn from other dimensions of the multiverse to cast spells, to conjure shields and weapons, to make magic.
I don't think that is the case. And here's why. Okay. Wait.
No. It's not at all what you think.
If we take a look in these video clips of Doctor Strange and other sorcerers who use traditional magic as described in the MCU, you notice that it's all kind of sparky and shiny and like lights and everything like that. Whereas Agatha, on the other hand, seems to have sort of wispy, cloudy magic. And the reason why I'm calling that out as being different is you notice in Age of Ultron, Wanda's magic is similar. We notice that it's just a shade of red. So I'm led to believe that Agatha is actually using powers from an Infinity Stone.
Well, I got a reaction to both those. Keith said that Agatha has an evil plan. And yes, I totally agree with that. But is it her plan? Or is she executing for somebody else? Just like Keith asked. But why? Why is she doing it? I think that it's not... just like, it's not on the surface. There's more to it, and that's what we're waiting for. As far as the Infinity Stones being responsible, I'm interested in that theory because, like Doug said, Wanda's magic is red, and Agatha's was purple, which is the Power Stone. So he could be onto something there. I don't know. I guess our nerddom can go either way.
Well, fellow nerds, I guess we'll just have to do another theory video on that.
Doug got pretty deep into some nerdy MCUism. I am now going to get knee-deep in some comic nerdism, and that is Avengers 187. In this comic, we learn a lot about Wanda and Pietro's history. we learn that they were not actually the wizard's kids. We find out that Magneto's wife comes to Wundagore and has these twins, but she doesn't want Magneto to know they're her kids. So they stay there, they get adopted, and then they go with the Maximoffs. But when they were born on Wundagore, Chthon was fighting basically the High Evolutionary. All these lights were going off, and while he was being pushed back into his dimension, he put a little bit of his power into Wanda Maximoff. Now, whether we're going to see this in WandaVision, I don't know. I don't know if Chthon is even going to be in it, but it is interesting to see that he tagged her as someone that he wants to come back in, a vessel for him later on. And I think we're going to see a lot of history. As I mentioned before, I think Agatha is going to go through her plan in episode 8 and maybe a little episode 9. I think we're also going to get Agatha's history way back with, you know, to keep her wedding anniversary is June 2nd, the start of the witch trials in Salem. So I think we're going to find out a lot about her history, maybe even how she got a hold of the Darkhold, if she did get it from Doctor Strange. We'll see that. But it all comes down to one thing. I think they're going to kind of follow the comics in this. As soon as I've been saying Mephisto since day one, I have now switched and changed my mind. Because of the history of the Darkhold, it is more aligned with Chthon and not Mephisto. So I have a feeling that all of this was done by Agatha to create basically Billy and Tommy, and that would be maybe using a part of Chthon to create them because it's her chaos magic and her reality kind of warping. It's going to pull some of Chthon into the MCU. And that is what the Darkhold needs, part of the spell progression that Agatha is following, to actually open it up and bring Chthon here so he can use Wanda as a vessel. But I don't think he's actually going to take possession of her, because Wanda's magic is hex magic and it can change the probability of things. So what I think is going to happen is Agatha is going to get to this final part of this spell to bring Chthon in and have him possess Wanda, but she is going to fire off some hex magic that causes it to go a little berserk. And that is where we're going to get the breaking of the multiverse, and that's going to lead directly into the multiverse of madness, and it's all going to be Wanda's fault. Even though she's going to be blamed, she actually probably saved the universe by stopping Chthon coming in.
I agree 100% with everything that Keith just said, with one little caveat. At the very end, Doctor Strange will show up, and that's the big cameo we all been waiting for that no one suspects. That's my guess. It's Doctor Strange to show up, say, all right, we got some work to do, something like that.
I partially agree with some of what Keith said, but that kind of brings me into one more thing that I want to mention about Agatha. My overarching idea after this last episode that we watched, I think it's going to turn out that the MCU is pulling another quick one on us, just like they did in Captain Marvel. Now, Keith has constantly been on a skrull watch from day one because he's looking for those evil skrulls hiding out and ready to wage war on the Earthlings. But so far, I'm not saying that he's wrong, but so far, the skrulls have been good in the MCU. And I think even though throughout most of her comic book life, where Agatha Harkness was considered relatively a good individual, she trained Wanda.
That's it. Restrain the dark impulses. See only the beauty.
She was involved with Mephisto here and there, and she did a couple of not-so-nice things occasionally, but overall, she was considered on the side of good in the comics. I think in the MCU, we're going to find out that it was Agatha all along.
Agatha all along. And I killed Sparky, too.
And that Agatha might actually be a bad guy. Ooh, I don't know if she's gonna turn out to be the big bad. I reference our last What's Next video where we still are in agreement that there probably is a big bad. I don't know who it's going to be yet. Again, still on the fence on that whole thing. But at the moment, this is where I'm leaning as far as Agatha is concerned.
I also want to lead back to the commercial with the shark and the Yo Magic, because I talked about it a couple videos ago, and I did say I think it was someone making a deal. I think we're going to find out in a flashback that it was Agatha and not Mephisto who is playing the role of the shark and came to Wanda and said, hey, would you like to get Vision back? I can give you this power, you know, join, do this, and I'll give you, make all your, you know, dreams come true. And I think we're going to find out that Agatha was the one who went to Wanda with promises of joy and happiness with Vision, bringing him back to life, and not Mephisto, like I've said way too many times. But I also have a theory about Dottie that I'll get to in just a moment.
That was the perfect segue into the commercials. Keith, thank you for mentioning that, because I have something that I want to briefly mention about this latest commercial that we saw in the last episode of WandaVision, where we are talking about the Nexus. This actually has a double meaning. Now, for those of our fellow nerds who are comic book readers, you may remember that the Nexus is a term that they use for very important characters who are constants in the multiverse. And we know that the multiverse is going to make an appearance in the MCU with Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, the newer Spider-Man that's going to be coming out, the Loki show that's going to be coming out. So we know that that is going to come up. And we know that from the comics, Wanda is considered a Nexus character. However, what a lot of people forget is in Age of Ultron, the word Nexus was used as sort of a hideaway where Jarvis hid away. It was a special port of the internet where Jarvis hid in order to protect himself from the Ultron AI. So it kind of has a double meaning in the world of Marvel, the comic book meaning, and in the MCU. So we'll have to see what all of this means. Is this going to be another tie-in to our theory that Ultron is going to be coming back? Or is this a reference that Wanda is a Nexus character? Or is it both?
The one thing that bothers me about the whole thing is throughout the show, all of the references to the devil and, you know, the devil's in the details and, you know, Ralph not being there, I still think that's got to lead somewhere. That's not really a theory, but I still think there's something out there regarding it. It can't all end with Agatha.
Is it a red herring, Dave?
The red herring.
And my final theory for the evening is all about Dottie. When we saw her kind of look over as Monica and Wanda were kind of having their showdown and Agnes came out, I think as Agnes gets closer, Agatha gets closer to her end game, I think she is losing hold of some of the citizens. And I think she's going to stop caring that she's controlling them. And I think that's going to help Wanda save the day, because I think Dottie is actually Clea, a sorcerer, compatriot of Doctor Strange, and I think she was sent to this town right before all of this went down to kind of check in and be like, whoa, there's a lot of mystical energies at work here. What's going on? And then she kind of got caught up in the whole hex. But once she starts getting her memory back, she's going to realize that she's a sorcerer of some power herself, and she's going to either A, call Doctor Strange, and like Dave said, we're going to see him show up at the end to lend a hand. And I think she's going to be teaming up with Wanda, Monica, Wong, Darcy, definitely the Vision, Billy and Tommy possibly, as long as nothing happens to them, as she's trying to create this gateway to bring Chthon or Mephisto in. And I think together they're going to put a stop to this for now, but I don't think it's going to be the end of Agatha Harkness, Chthon, Mephisto, whatever else is going on. But I do have a stinking suspicion that Dottie is actually Clea in the MCU.
That is a really good theory, Keith, and I gotta say, it ties nicely into a couple of references that were dropped throughout WandaVision, especially when Agnes mentions that Dottie kind of runs things. She sort of references this all the way back in episode 2.
Dottie is the key to everything in this town. Country club memberships, parties, school admissions.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
You get in with Dottie and it'll be smooth sailing from here on out. Just mind your P's and Q's and you're gonna do just fine.
So, that is an excellent theory and I think you're onto something.
And also, while talking about team-ups, if you did stay for the mid-credit scene on the last episode, if you haven't, go back and watch it. We'll wait. Okay, so now you know that Monica was looking down in the basement and Pietro kind of came up and said, Snooper's gonna snoop. Is he there to help Agatha? Or is he there to help Wanda, Monica, and the rest of the new Avengers that are kind of forming on his thing? Because we saw her magic in the Agatha all along, kind of pushing him into the house and setting him there. And we we saw him kind of gaslighting Wanda and kind of pushing her down a path that we think was Agatha's. But was she controlling him? Or is Pietro actually somebody else? Senior Scratchy, something else, you know, transmorgified into Pietro? And is he going to be joining with Agatha against the group? At this point, it's hard for me to tell. I have been against him being Pietro from another universe for the longest time, but knowing that she has the power of the Darkhold behind her makes me think it's very likely she knew she needed someone like Pietro and she couldn't get it from that universe, so she plucked him from another universe and brought him into that.
And who is that imposter, Pietro?
It's me.
I think it's becoming more likely that that is actually Pietro Maximoff from the X-Men universe or another universe that just doesn't look like the one from the MCU.
Exactly, because he's coming from a different universe. There is no way she could have brought Pietro back from this universe because he's dead. So she had to go to another universe and pull Pietro out of that one. I agree.
So are you saying that I've won you guys over? Huh? You like my nerdy theories? Yeah.
Doug, I will admit, after watching last week's video with you breaking down how the different speed comes off each of these guys, it definitely helps sway me into thinking this is Pietro Maximoff from the X-Men universe. Is that going to mean that we are going to see more X-Men at the end of this? If my theory is right and she sends a hex into this, bringing Chthon into our universe that breaks the multiverse, are we going to see Magneto? Are we going to see Charles Xavier? Are we going to see the Beast? Or who, you know, who we could see? It could really break this whole thing wide open and really lead to the multiverse of madness.
I'm glad you guys liked my theory about the speed wave idea. That's right, I'm still calling it TMCR, speed waves. You've heard it here first, not your status quo. We've trademarked it, copyrighted it. That's our word now. And Marvel, if you want to use it, you got to come talk to us. Maybe we'll cut a deal, a couple million, you know, whatever. Anyway, I still believe that this is a Pietro or a Peter from another universe. I cannot guarantee that this is the one from the Fox universe. But yeah, I still think it's the idea that he has the ability of super speed, unless this MCU version of Agatha Harkness found a way to give super speed to somebody, then I'm led to believe that he is a speedster from another universe.
Don't believe anything that man said. He is not your uncle.
Who is he?
But those were all of our theories for WandaVision in the next couple of episodes. We want to know what you guys think. So let us know in the comments down below and stay tuned for more Not Your Status Quo. See you in the next one.